Hello everybody, Iron Inquisitor here, and I wanted to do a review on the Star Wars comic Jedi vs. Sith. This Jedi vs. Sith came out in 2001, and it was a story that depicted the battles on the planet Ruusan between the Jedi and the Sith. So what do I think of the comic? No, before I get to that, the comic tells the point of view of three cousins that are force sensitive and are being recruited to fight the Sith. And you know, alright, so what do I think of the comic? I liked it. I mean, it's not my favorite Star Wars comic. The artwork is like really cartoony. And it doesn't match the tone of the story at all, which is incredibly dark. There's like, it really shows the grittiness and the bloodiness of war. And yeah, the artwork is just like cartoony and kid friendly. And there were some things that were kind of predictable about the story, like, you know which character is going to fall to the dark side. You can see it coming from the beginning. However, there is one character, when I first read this as a kid, that I didn't expect to fall to the dark side. And another notable thing about this comic is you get to see Darth Bane. That's pretty cool. There is a few contradictions between this that the Darth Bane trilogy later contradicted. There's a few things that happened in here that the Bane trilogy later contradicted. And it was something that, when I first read this comic, like, really freaked me out as a kid. Because I was, like, in, what, third, fourth grade when I first read this comic. Spoiler alert, for those of you who have not read it. But I'm going to say what it is that freaked me out. Okay, so in the comic, there's a part where Darth Bane goes to see the remnants of the Thought Bomb, and right before he's about to leave, Githany comes out, and she's this really, really scary as hell, creepy, shriveled up, mummified husk with one eyeball, and she's talking, and ugh, and she still has hair on her head. When I read that, that scared the shit out of me, and I think it's kind of cool now, but I still find it to be really creepy. That's why I really don't like to read the last issue that much, because of that scene. So would I recommend Jedi vs. Sith? If you are a huge fan of the Darth Bane trilogy, and you kind of want to know the backstory of the characters, like, Bane's apprentice and her cousin, you know, I would really recommend this. But I would only recommend reading this either after you've read Path of Destruction or Rule of Two. Either or. But, yeah, I would recommend it to those things. There's a few things people like to complain about this comic, like how the whole Lord of the Rings aesthetic, which I had no problem with, because this is a dark age. Technology kind of regressed, and the Jedi are so desperate for weapons and such, so it doesn't really matter. And people also hate Valentine Farfalla's gunship, the Fairwind, I think it's called. People think, oh, that's stupid, it has a unicorn on the front, and it is made of wood. honestly, I've never minded that. I mean, there's always lots of weird stuff in Star Wars, even in the movies. And I think it also really fits Valentine Farfalla's flamboyant personality. So I never really had that much of a problem. Much of a problem with the Ferrowind. So, yeah, go check this comic out. I think they might have done a Marvel reprint of it. I'm not sure. So, yeah. What do you think of Jedi vs. Sith? Tell me in the comments. And give me a like, give me a subscribe. And may the Force be with you.